given that Origin can see that the Sylas locked in, of course there was the option for Splice to either put the Sylas in the jungle or put it in the mid lane. Origin push, which then allows him to get priority, and then work with his jungler to set up invades. But of course, when going up against an Elise, it's not always the best thing, as an all-in happens bar.
Ignite onto Cobby, he's gonna fall. First blood goes down to Origin, they strike first.
Infernal Drake, and I think, as we mentioned, this is a very important Drake for them. Handing it over to Origin is really not what you want to do. So this is going to hurt them in the long run.
Going, in with the Glacial Fissure. TP's coming out from Splice and from Origin. Two TP's from Splice. It's going to be a 4v3 for the moment. Nuke Duck caught up. Counter teleport in by Origin. The charm comes out by Mythi onto the backline. Cobby's jumped forward. He flashes away. He dodges away. But Afami lands the counter strike. And now Cobby's so low, he's ticking down. He will fall. Origin get their second kill of the game. Patrick and Afami are going to be able to jump out. But Humanoid's going back in, trying to go for the trade. Stopwatch from Patrick will stop them in their tracks. And Origin find the kill and get out of dodge. He is the bouncer for the team. VIP is Patrick and Alfari in his back pocket. Alfari's going to get the tower in the bottom lane as Splice look for the Rift Herald. Origin are in the position to react to this. The dredge line comes out. Noskeman on the front line. It's a 3v4 for the moment. Cobby coming in from the back side. The repel up by Humanoid. And here they go. Cobby jumping in. Rift Herald goes down. Zanzara's the one to secure it. Chachi is going to get a kill onto the Gragas though. And the rest of Splice are chasing in. Braum will fall. Nuke Duck stunned up. He'll go down as well. Splice get two.
Now remember that OG got on a free time to secure this Drake.
I'm not sure the Rift Herald used in mid got them the Drake. I think Splice just backing off.
Back to the games.
Yeah, because I'm not saying they're better than Fnatic and G2.
But at that one specific
thing. Maybe a diving top lane tower. Chachi with a great knife into the wall and Mythi falls. Chachi's so tanky. How far is going to be able to get away from this
one? That down. Splice yet to break one of these towers. They will get bot in just a second. So it's 2-for-1 on the turret score. Still that 2,000
now. As of yet, we can see the Trinity Force now available on Alfari. I imagine that he's going to feel very comfortable and strong in terms of the 1v1. He can act as that go button, that trigger that can encourage and enable Origin where sometimes into the top side jungle, they could actually assure that he was safe to siege onto this tower. So they take half the health, now they could be looking at a fight.
Zanzara just used his ultimate. Dredge line coming in by Nuke Duck. He's stunned up. Now scaring down to half HP. The depth charge comes out, hits onto Cobby on the backline. Nuke Duck, the charm's coming out. Nuke Duck flashes away, but Cobby's on the chase. He'll get him. And now this fight on the top side of the fight keeps going on. Chachi flashes away, but Humanoid gets into the middle of them all with the Kingslayer. He heals up, and it's a double for Cobby. He's looking for more. Alfari jumps in with a leap strike, but the rest of Splice are on the chase. Origin having to back away. Patrick down to about half HP. Splice. Multiple stack on the Elder Dragon, but Splice will look up towards the Baron. The people that we said like to keep their hair good while playing rugby, which I think is what happens here. Chachi jumping in with the Blast Cone, and Mythi and Patrick are waiting for them.
CS advantage over his lane counterpart in Nuke Duck. He has 9.7k gold now, and he is definitely very, very strong.
He definitely is. We do see the Blade of the Ruin King here, second item on Chachi. He's gone towards that. He's just trying to get as much damage in these fights as possible. Origin pushing in the mid lane will almost take down the turret. Meanwhile, in the bottom lane, Alfari gets one for himself. Patrick gets the tower in the end, and that's two more in the back pockets of Origin. Still only about 2,000.
One of the biggest difference maker is how much more value Gragas offers. Ooh, fight kicking off.
Hook landing onto Humanoid, knocked up, airborne. He goes golden, but there's no escape from the rest of Origin. Shut down. Team fights, maybe a bit of engage as well if you can find it, but Mythi's been the one to go in most of the time. Patrick jumping forward here, Mythi with the charm. Doesn't land onto Norskare, and a beautiful Glacial Fissure will stop him in his tracks, but Chachi's down towards the bottom side, and once again, he's been caught out. Afari on the chase. The depth charge connects, but Alfari can't quite get there. He was slowed up with the boomerang. There's the Blade of the Ruin King, but it's not enough.
Alfari, so he could look to come in from behind.
Blank position for Alfari. 4v5 in favor of Origin. Mythi on the front line. Norskare and Xerxes. Cobby, Cuba would have to do something huge here. The depth charge is going to come out. Mythi caught out, but it dives onto the back line. Patrick almost down. Cobby takes him out, and now it's a 4v4. Xerxes gone up. Mythi goes down. Another kill comes out. Alfari on the chase. Nuke's going to get a stun off, and it's Alfari on Nuke Dog catching out Cobby, assassinating him. Zanzara will kill Norskaren,
and it comes down to execution as well. And it only takes one bad fight to swing the game. Now we see Alfari.
Gets the counter strike off, but here comes Cobby straight onto him. And maybe the execution is Alfari going down. Now Origin on the chase. Mythi has the charm. The knockback onto Norskaren. Alfari able to dodge out of the back of it, dodging out all those shots. Norskaren on the front line has been killed by Patrick, and the rest of Origin are here for the pass.
The flash already used.
Oh, the explosive cast was dodged away from. And Nuke Duck still on the chase. Teleport coming in here by Splice. The Gnar into the wall. Zanzara's the one to be caught out. Counter strike from Alfari. Gets the double stun. Chachi down into mini Gnar. And here comes the damage. The charm on the backline. Origin have found their fight. They're just going to demolish Splice here. There's nothing Splice can do about it at all. It's a double kill for both Patrick and for Alfari. And it felt like the writing had been on the wall for a while.
Origin should at least be able to break open the base here, if not take the win.
Clean ace and easy fight from the side of Origin. You talked about the double TP, but all Splice did was TP into their demise. This should be an opportunity for Origin to end the game and take game one of this best of five.
Great stuff by Origin. They're going to push in this top wave, go for those Nexus Towers, and they will be 1-0 up in this series. It was a slower game as expected from both these two teams, but it's Origin who strike first, and they are 1-0 up in the regional gauntlet.